Alright, a little bit of change of plans today. I was going to keep doing some work on additive, but actually I have a couple others that I've got to squeeze in here in the middle of all that, so it's a new blank, well, new-ish blank. First time I'm going to make a full pen out of it. It's the material I was using for the front sections on the elementals. This was air, I think. So let's see if we can knock out a real pen in the middle of everything else I've been doing. Give you guys a little bit something more to see other than just me doing repetitive cuts over and over. Alright, off we go. A different mount for the camera today, so hopefully it won't shake too much and you guys will get a little bit closer look at the work in progress instead of being way over my shoulder to my right. A second, I'll see if you're able to see the whole blank or not. I gotta stop and look at the phone. Yeah. Let's see. Yep, that'll work. Alright, step one is to rough turn this down to a respectable size for what I need. They do that. That'll work itself out here in a minute, momentarily. That's actually not the cutter I want. That's the cutter I want. And we're going to hog a whole bunch off at one time. To the diameter I want here. Actually, we'll do this in two passes because that's about where I want to be. I'll back off a little bit. First pass can be... Yeah, we'll do it there. Guard on that lead screw. That drives me nuts. good news is once I get the DRO installed, I won't have to sit here and mic this stuff all the time. I can just dial it in on a screen and say, perfect. But in the meantime, I'm going the long way. Picked up or built lathe stops or carriage stops yet. There you go. That works. Do a little switcheroo on the dies here. Different thread size than the pens I'm doing for additive on my normal lineup, just because the other threads are the ones that Jerry was set up for with all his 3D printing, so I adapted to him rather than make him adapt to me. Hangs out with me in the shop while I'm working a lot. Alright. What you up to? Nothing. I asked you what you were up to. What you doing? You're just sitting? Nope. I'm here. Ryan and Justin are inside too. Yeah.
At school.
What's at school? No, they're home. Ryan's in his computer. Justin's upstairs. They knew I was out here. I told them to keep an eye on you. You were hiding. Yeah, you shut your door and you were hiding from me. Silly.
Yeah.
that I don't know. Sooner. Man, a D. A D for what?
Mommy.
What, D for Daddy?
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Smile, you're on camera.
Camera.
Right there. Magic. Daddy magic. Alright. Since I use a threaded converter.
What's a threaded converter?
A threaded converter. It's a piece of a pen.
Piece of a pen?
Nope, I was just making some threads so that I can screw something in there.
Screw what in there?
A threaded converter. Hey. Hey now. Hey, you probably should not be standing there while I'm... got the tool running, you know that, right?
Well,
that was a lot. Go a little bit deep because... get corrected on the other side for the nib since it's a little bit bigger.
What nib?
And I'd rather be threaded as deep as I need now than to have to try and chuck it up after I've shaped it. That doesn't work. Alright. Stop back in. And
I felt the breeze.
Okay. That's gonna make me cold. Gonna make me cold? Is that what you're trying to do?
I'm going silly.
Why not?
No.
Are you silly? One of these days I'll make a jig to reset my stop for this, but not today.
Did you feel it?
I did. Yeah, I'll tell you what, why don't you wear these while I'm working since you're close enough? Don't want anything flying up and hitting you in the eye. Right? All kinds of trouble. about where I want to be. 11-9. Spot on. What are you doing? What are you doing? You gotta have those glasses on. You really should have shoes on, too. Nah. Uh-huh. Okay. Don't go anywhere. You're about. I see that. That's a good place to keep them. Just don't lose them. It's been a while since I've used this. It was in my old machinist box. I know, this is probably boring some of y'all to death, right? Thought it was going to be exciting, fun-filled journey, but that's alright. It's all in good fun. Yeah, that stop got pushed back. Wow. Alright. I need to put a second set screw on that stop.
I know how to do the sleep pull.
How to do what?
Sleep pull, like this and then
this. Good job. Where, at school? To go inside.
Yeah.
Why?
And the dog was outside and I left the door open.
Oh. So now he's inside, right?
It says
little girls don't touch.
Hey, where is that another hand?
Don't know.
There's two those. There's two X's.
What sound?
Something
you just make. The squeak sound?
No, the sound. Blowing. Can I try?
You can, just don't. There we go, that's better. You need to chase those threads again. And.
Is this a tool?
That is a tool. Just blowing the dust out.
Can I look? Can I try?
It's one of my K6 converters.
I'm just trying to blow through it.
Here, you do one of those. Just don't lose it. That's important, okay? Alright, so if all goes well, there we go. Converter threads in. All I gotta do is take it over the other lathe and shape it, but let me go ahead and start knocking out a cap and a body first. Is that where that goes?
It blows out through this, right?
Mm-hmm.
It blows out differently when I blow through this. See?
She's our entertainment. Now, nah, don't do that. I don't want to see how that's got those holes in there like that. If you push it on there, it could scratch them up and ruin them, and I'd have to start all over again. So you don't want to put that anywhere it's not supposed to go.
Okay.
Before
I brush it.
You can. You know what? Here. Why don't I give you one of these? Why don't you take that one? And I'll take that one back. Is that okay?
Yeah.
You can have that one. Hey, put your glasses back on.
But I have a hole and I couldn't. And I don't want. I just don't want one of them.
I need to make a longer mandrel. This little thing's just a little stub. Alright, on to a buddy. Ourselves a buddy. Everybody. If you start singing on me. Oh, you're repeating me. Is that what we're doing? You're repeating me. I think you're repeating me. And not that I need to use it, but one of the fun features of this lathe. Making it go the right way again. Power crossfeed. Like I said, not that I actually need it for this, I just wanted to show off. Anyway. Alright, so yeah. And with our regularly scheduled program. Guys, I know there's some comments on the video. I will, I'll get back to them when I'm done here so I don't have to keep checking behind the phone. And I'll respond to them on Instagram later tonight or whatever. So if you've got questions, comments, thoughts, concerns, etc., ask away. I will see them. Just won't see them right now. I'm going to make this tenon a little bit longer. Paying attention. Oops. Yeah. Okay. Bye-bye this tenon. Turned it too small. Maybe this time I'll pay a little bit more attention to what I'm doing. What do you think, Alley Cat? Should I pay more attention to what I'm doing? For 13, we got 13.047. I think that's well within where I want to be. Actually, let's get this the heck out of the way because we got to polish that tenon before I can thread it. I won't get a chance later. up all my air. I'm going to turn that compressor on. It's going to scare you. You don't want me to turn the compressor on, do you? The one that you're using up all my air is almost gone. That's all right. Use it up. I'll turn it on later. You helping me out by cleaning the garage door? Is that what you're doing? I'm not going to show you what that is. Magic. Liquid magic. No. Seriously, it's actually just autosol. Autosol metal polish. It does a good job on alumilite. Yeah, most plastics, actually. It's just enough abrasive to kind of polish that glass a little bit up. That's not going to be super shiny until I buff it, but it's the last of the scratches out. Alright, like I said, we'll buff that a little bit later. Maybe on camera, maybe off camera, we'll see. Alright. A little bit more threading action. Make sure we got the right. Yep. Big old machinery that can cut 375,000 different types of threads and sizes and pitch, and good old die still does the job in no time flat, so I don't see any reason to mess with changing gears around or anything like that. It gives me, a die right there gives me triple start, so it's got three individual leads for fast close, about a 0.8 metric pitch, 13 millimeters in diameter. A lot of technical babble that just says, hey, your pen's going to close pretty quick and be nice, stable threads, etc., etc. Marketeering. Hey, you don't have your glasses on. Seriously, if you're going to be right there, you got to have your glasses on. Otherwise, I'm going to have to stop and we'll have to go inside. Marketeering. All right. What is that? A cookie to eat because you can have a cookie to eat. Oh, turn thread drill, turn thread drill, turn thread drill. That's pen making in a nutshell. Spark. I get a little bit crazy when I'm working, but hey, if you can't have fun, why do it? Heaven. 3 inches of throw on this tailstock. The last one I'd get about an inch and a half in, and that'd be all she wrote. Beautiful. Anybody knows how to stop that chatter? I'm all ears. Brand new reamers, nice and sharp. I think it's just the material. Could be speed if I'm going too fast, too slow. Say so. Where in the world? Where's my 10mm tap? And I've been doing additive for the last however long, and all my stuff sitting in my other machinist box. The shop had to go through a little bit of an overhaul to make room for the new lathe, so things got put not at my fingertips, which gets annoying after a while. We'll remedy that here soon. Should have a something resembling a pen here. She used up all my air. All right, survey says. Ooh, that's a tight fit. Survey says we gotta do some work on that thread right there. But at the end of the day, it will fit. I will make it fit. I have the tools, I have the technology. Alright, so I actually want to. What do I want to do? Little cheat sheets here. You didn't see these, don't exist. I'm going to part that at about 85, 40. Ooh, I'm missing a dimension. Wow. All right. It's a good thing it's to scale. I'm part that at, I'm going to give ourselves some wiggle room. I'll call it about Don't yell at me. Chuck Key was in there, I know. Had somebody yell at me for that yesterday. I know better. Get preoccupied. I forget to take Chuck Key out. Forward, dummy. Hey, look, a pin body. Progress is good. Misplacing your stuff is bad. All right. And next up is cap. Do when you got a black oxide drill bit? Use a silver sharpie. Again, need to make some more collars. I just no time. Flying by the seat of my pants on this one. Next part would be a boring bar, but I don't have a boring bar holder yet for the right size for this thing, so we'll do it the old-fashioned way. Nice and true. Oh, love it. Love it, love it, love it. I need to do a little finessing on the threads. It's, well, it's dirty. Gunk up my threads. But, once all said and done, I'll have to come back later and show you the how to finish it off for good, but essentially, there's all your pen pieces. Section, body, cap. Put them all together. And you have to chase your threads again, but anyway, put them all together and that will be a pen eventually. So at this point, I'm signing off because, well, it's about dinner time and I'm going to spend some time with the family, but I'll come back later. I'll clean up these threads, get everything nice and smooth, screwing together the way it's supposed to, and then we'll take it over to the wood lathe, and that's when you get to see some of the artistic side, hand shaping. Put a profile on some of that, put a nice curve on there, round that off, make a little cigar shape out of it, I think. And that material's awesome. That's gonna look good. All right, yep, I think that's it for me for right now, so.
See ya.